Welcome to part 2 of this series on how we made this beautiful 3D HeroQuest board. In this video, we're going to be painting it up and making it look beautiful, so let's head straight to the workshop and get to work. To seal the board and give it a really good foundation for painting, we coated the entire board in Mod Podge. We mixed the Mod Podge with black acrylic paint so we would already have a dark foundation for the rest of the paint job. We spread the Mod Podge and paint mixture over the entire board with a large brush. We made sure to cover the sides of the first layer of the bricks, but we didn't coat the top because we wanted the additional layers of bricks to be glued right to the foam to increase their structural integrity. The next step was to apply a coat of primer, but we also didn't want the primer to cover the top of the first layer of bricks either. So, we applied a layer of masking tape to the tops of the bricks to protect them. Then we took it all outside for a coat of black primer. It's always amazing how a coat of primer can unify a project and make it start to look like something that's more than just the sum of its parts. Once the primer was dry, it was time to start painting the board. This is what we've all been waiting for. A while ago, I bought the complete collection of Army Painter paints, so we went through that box and started pairing paint colors with the main color of each room on the original HeroQuest board. Most rooms and most colors ended up being a blend and mix of paints, but this did give us a good starting point. The next step was just to pick a room and start applying paint. We were careful only to apply paint to the tops of all the tiles in each room. This would leave the black Mod Podge and primer in all of those recesses, and all that detail that we inscribed into the board would stand out. We spent a considerable amount of time mixing colors and painting the board. In most cases, it took 2 or 3 coats of paint to get the paint to cover just the way we wanted it. And by the way, it was completely the right decision to paint the floor without the walls fully built. It made this painting process so much easier. Once the base colors of paint had been applied, we needed to weather it. We did that in a variety of ways with washes and paint applied with sponges and brushes. Once again, we kept the original HeroQuest board close by so we could reference it constantly. We tried to replicate as much of the shading and texture as we could. We really took our time with this because it was a very satisfying part of the project, and during this time we started to realize that the board was, in fact, coming together the way we envisioned it. We also carefully painted additional detail onto the HeroQuest logo at the bottom of the board. We used thin black markers to draw on some of this detail. We tried to match the color of this part of the board as closely as we could. That ended up taking several different washes and paint textures to get it looking exactly the way we wanted. Once the floor had been painted, it was time to think about painting the walls. We wanted to do this with spray paint because we thought that would be the fastest and easiest way to get it done, but that did mean that we were going to have to mask off the entire floor. So we got to work with blue masking tape to cover it all up. This kind of made it look like painter's drop cloths had been placed throughout the entire dungeon, because maybe Zargon was having some dungeon renovation done. But on the other hand, that is kind of what's happening here though. With the masking tape applied to the floor, it was time to go back and cut and texture more foam bricks. We made a huge pile of them so that we could build up all of the walls. We had previously decided that the walls would be 3 bricks high, so we carefully built them up straight. You can see we peeled the masking tape off the tops of the bricks to expose the Mod Podge and primer-free foam. Then it was back to the blackened Mod Podge. It was so nice to be able to apply this to the walls without worrying about messing up the beautiful paint job on the floor. Masking it off was totally worth it. And there it is. All the walls are Mod Podged, and it's ready to go outside for painting. We used the Uniform Gray Paint and Primer from Army Painter as our base color for the walls, and I think it was a great choice. The classic dungeon gray works really well for the HeroQuest board, because it is a classic dungeon after all, and this color gray had a little bit of blue in it that also works really well for this paint scheme. The next step was to do a dry brush of a lighter color gray onto all of the bricks. This brought out some of the texture and kept the walls from being just a solid gray. Here again, it was really nice to be able to do this without having to worry about messing up the floor. Once the dry brushing was done, it was time for the big reveal. Peeling off masking tape once painting is complete is always so satisfying. I'll just let you watch for a bit. Next, I decided to add a bit of structural integrity to the board, so I took a thin piece of 1/4 inch thick plywood and cut it so it was 1/2 inch larger than the board in both directions. I applied a dark stain to the plywood and then mounted the board to it so there would be a quarter of an inch of plywood all the way around. I used construction adhesive to attach it and clamped it down. This plywood foundation helps keep the board rigid and also protects the board a bit so that if you bang it into a wall or door jamb as it's being moved, the plywood takes the hit and not your game board. It also adds a nice frame and finishing touch to the whole project. That is close to a finished HeroQuest game, but now we have to paint the miniatures, build the doors, paint the furniture, and also make a few other extras that make HeroQuest special.